23 this year, and I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder. Most common, I guess, way to describe it when I'm at a party or whatever, as an icebreaker, is it's a roller coaster. Bipolar 2, bipolar, so North and South Pole. Yeah, it's a roller coaster of funs, highs and lows, and like all roller coasters, people are scared.
I was diagnosed with schizophrenia, which was comorbid with depression, when I was 19 years old. This illness is something that you would always have to take care of. It's something that does not completely go away. There might always be a relapse, you never know.
I am caring for my daughter, Sumaya. She was diagnosed with schizophrenia when she was 19, her first year going to the university.
I want to care for my husband. He got the old man's Alzheimer's. When he was sick, he was okay. 3 years later, 他就好像记忆力什么都比较差劲了。
I put a lot of pressure on myself to do well and to be the best student that I could possibly be, which is good, but I took it to the extreme. So because I was so stressed up over essays and assignments, I would not sleep because it was too stressful for me. So the longest stretch I went without sleep was 7 days, and that happened twice. So that does things to your mind.
One particular weekend, when she came back, it was really quite a shock for me because she told us suddenly that she hadn't been sleeping for 1 week. So I thought that was quite a serious thing. So the same night, we went to bring her to see a GP.
My parents had to bring me to the doctor where I was treated. So that period was confusing, very difficult.
It took a lot out of me when I was going through the episodes and when it wasn't controlled, but it gave me immense fortitude and courage to take on anything that came my way, or anything that does come my way now in the rest of my life.
It affected my work because I was in retail. You know, every day you come to work, you have to be happy, show a smiling face, make people happy. It was very difficult, but I refuse to cry or even be sad. You know, I need to do my job well, and I need to be strong.
You know, they have that six-step program thing where, you know, you go through denial and all that. I think it just at the end, when you finally get to that last stage of acceptance, I think that was like the turning point of finally accepting, yeah, I need to take meds, yeah, I need to manage my stress, yeah, I need to look out for triggers. And once I really understood that I had to embrace it as part of who I was, and had to start to understand that I have bipolar disorder, but I'm not suffering from it, and it's not who I am, but it is a part of who I am. That then really helped me out, I think, going forward.
For someone who feels that they might be having a mental illness, I would really encourage them to seek professional help. There are plenty of counselors, doctors, social workers who can give them the advice, the medical support that they need. Don't be afraid to seek help, because there are many people and many organizations that are willing to provide the support that you need. Don't think that you're alone in this situation. Yeah, there's plenty of support if you just reach out. Yeah. To not stigmatize people with mental illness, because they have a lot of things that they can do and offer. I am a person with mental illness, but I'm not defined by this mental illness. I have hopes, I have dreams, I have things that I would like to achieve in this life, and things that I have already achieved in this life.
Knowing that I couldn't do the stuff, some stuff that I wanted to do, but it was also quite freeing to know that a lot of other doors were still open, and once I came to that realization, I think it became a lot easier to live my life.
For caregivers, you have to remember you are the pillar of strength. So you need to take care of yourself first. You need to be mentally prepared patient and don't lose hope, because for some the journey might be long, but there's always cure. You just think of the cure is there.
要照顾自己的健康，才有办法照顾到这个病人。他有健康了，我们就是开心。
If you think someone's going through something, just be there for them. Don't try to provide advice unless they ask for advice. And if you think they need aid, help steer them towards proper aid. If you can't help, into professional aid or someone who you think has more experience in it. For people who are going through it, I think just remember that help is real, hope is real, and that all of us' story is unwritten. If you can make it through one day, you can make it to the next, and the next, and the next. Just really just the optimistic.